Being your own boss brings a level of complete independence that working for another doesn't. You get to decide how you do business, how you treat your clients, customers, vendors, and how you prioritise and divide your time. In this week's BIC Soleil, Your Shine Your Way edition, we're joined by one beautiful lady who knows this all too well. Lifestyle content creator and blogger, Clarice Cairncross, who will be chatting to us about being your own boss. Welcome to the loft, Clarice.
Thank you for having me here.
You seem to have be your own boss, think down and waxed, girl. You're a blogger, a lifestyle creator, and a model. So what was your deciding factor on doing things independently? And how then do you balance all aspects?
Okay, so a deciding factor for me was I believe in giving back. So I am a multi-passionate multitasker. So since primary school, you know, I've been involved in so many things and not only my schoolwork, if I can put it that way. So Instagram really became a platform for me where I could start to give back and collaborate with well-known brands while connecting with like-minded people, which really grew on me.
Now, Clarice, you're also, though, a social worker for bone marrow donors, and you are constantly flying to different hospitals around South Africa. So why is this close to your heart?
I've always had the personality type that craves challenges. So, you know, being creative, having the ability to make an impact, and more important, to make an impact on other people's lives. So I always knew I had to go into a field that's either psychology or law. So, you know, after being with a few professionals and shadowing them, I believe that, you know, social work is the part for me to go into. And I never even thought about that because I come from a community where social work is like connected with removing kids, and people only think that social work is about that. And actually, when I went into the field and shadowed one social worker that was from a community which is Otsun, I realized, you know, that social workers actually, they are clinicians, they are counselors, wow, they're case managers, and they are advocates for change. So then, when I told people had predominantly negative responses. It was like, you really want to remove kids. Are you sure you have the abilities or you have the heart to do this? But, you know, yeah, I am. So it's 5 years later. I'm completing my master's degree and I'm caring for stem cell donors all across South Africa. So, in fact, I would say the greatest pleasure in life is doing something other people say you cannot do.
Absolutely. You know, you have to take that challenge head on and say, I will be the champion regardless. What advice do you have for ladies who are out there that just started their own business venture, or of course, those that are considering it?
So I would say, you know, don't let the fear of someone's, like, else's beliefs stop you from pursuing your goals. Because just because they have like a set of beliefs or like a mindset, it doesn't mean that it applies to you. So I've been in your shoes, girl. Chin up, princess. Go for your goals.
I love those. I want to. That I think that's going to be the caption for my next IG post.
Yes, I would look out for that.
And how important is finding your shine through being your own boss and letting your success shine through?
I would say it's important because you're literally testing your own abilities or capabilities, I can say, which is a wonderful, wonderful way to rely on yourself and to create your own success. So for me, it was like working on both my personal and professional development. So I was through reaching like your own goals and making your success shine through, you literally became a coach or like a mentor to other ladies. And I remember what effort and courage it took me to be where I am today.
Thank you so much. I think when I listen to you talk, I can listen forever because you speak with such sincerity, honesty, but also, you know, you're just real at the end of the day. So I really appreciate you stopping by and sharing your shine with us here on Afternoon Express. Clarice Cairncross, we really appreciate it. All the best with all your future endeavors. Goodbye.
Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Now there's only 1 week left to win one of three BIC Miss Soleil sensitive hampers to the value of 500 rand each. To stand a chance of winning this week, all you have to do is tell us how you own your shine like a boss using the hashtag #YourShineYourWay. Share your answer on the competition post on Afternoon Express's Facebook or Twitter page and cross those fingers. This week's competition closes at 6 p.m. on Friday the 9th of October, so please do get entering. Terms and conditions do apply and can be found on afternoonexpress.co.za. Your shine, your way, with BIC Soleil.